Hello and welcome to yet another very influential episode of Women Influencers Talk Show. As Isadora James once said, that a sister is a gift to the heart, a friend to the spirit, and a golden thread to the meaning of life. Yes, we all know that if we have a sister, we have a friend, a companion, and a therapist for life. I am so delighted to introduce a fabulous sister duo on today's episode. They are young, they are charged up, and ready to take on the world. Yes, they have taken such huge responsibility over their shoulders, and they are very popularly known as the Social Activist Sisters. I welcome you, Ananya and Sanjoli Banerjee, on Women Influencers Talk Show. This is the first time that we have a duo on this show, and it's such a great feeling. How are you both doing?
Hi, Sadaf. Thanks for having us, first of all. It's a pleasure to be here. And we both are doing good. How about yourself?
I'm fine, thank you so much, and I'm so glad to have you both here. So, Ananya, you are 17, and Sanjoli, you are 21. While most of the girls of your age are busy with fashion, makeup, and selfies, to name a few things, you both are social activists. So how different or similar is your ideology about life to those of other girls of your age?
Yeah, so regarding that, Sadaf, I think it works both ways. So we are similar to most of the other girls, and we are very ordinary in that manner. Because we also like to be with our families, play with a dog, or go out with friends and enjoy our routine school or college life.
Undoubtedly, but at the same time, we are a little different from others maybe, because at a very young age, we got a purpose of life. We found our true calling in social activism, and maybe that's why, being a teenager, I didn't find interest in fashion but in social activism. So I think we are both similar and different at the same time.
And I'd say everyone is unique. So if someone finds true calling in makeup or fashion, why not pursue it and make it a profession? So it's all about actually excelling at what you do and finding your passion at the end of the day.
I second that. Now, as I got to know that the moving force behind the social activity was a personal encounter that charged your lives, please share the story with us.
Well, it started in around 2003, when Ananya was about to be born. And my mother, in fact, was expecting her. And the society in general, and some of our neighbors and extended family, they were trying to pressurize my mom to go for an abortion just because they were going to have another daughter. So I was already there, and then she was expected, thinking that my parents would have to become security guards, because girls are unsafe and girls are a liability. So marrying them off, educating them, ultimately to send them to another house. So that mentality basically, I think, pushed us into this field. Of course, my mother resisted the pressures, and my parents together decided to, of course, have her. And her birth gave us meaning in our lives, actually. And we started off our journey against female feminicide initially, and then we took up other causes.
Exactly. So later on, in summer 2009, we started with the climate change campaign for environmental preservation. We went for a 4,500 kilometer expedition. And very soon, when we started reading newspapers and found that everywhere we could have only news about abortion and cutting down of trees, so we thought of directing our energy towards social activism. Once our parents introduced to the field, but then we both found it a true calling. And so recently we started the Su Shiksha campaign as well. And that was Sanjoli's brainchild, because when she came back from the world-class university studying in Australia, so it was her desire to not keep the knowledge to herself, rather contribute to the society, and especially plug in the gap between the urban and rural kids through awareness and education. So I think overall all the campaigns have been a collective effort of both of us, where we put in our energy and minds together.
Yeah, I think it basically runs in the blood, I'd say. Our parents first introducing this us to us, and then Ananya and I always thinking on the same lines. Like even when it was about Su Shiksha, when I shared my idea with her initially, she actually had the same ideology. We had the same perspective towards things in the society. So yeah, things have made their way out.
That's wonderful. And believe me, I can see that gleam in your eyes, and that shows how proud you are of your work. That is fantastic. Sanjoli, you were awarded the Exceptional Child Award by the Government of Haryana at the age of 7. Please tell us something about what committed you to social work at that tender age.
Yeah, oh yes. So I was honored by the state government of Haryana. I was invited at the Chief Minister House for this prestigious award. And I think the entire credit primarily goes to my parents for this, because at the age of 7, at this tender age, as you said, a child is not really aware about the environment or about the outside world, but it is actually what you introduce to that impressionable mind that they carry and form their perception like that. So I think that is the first thing, and later I think I started enjoying the process, and also how like I would actually be very participative in all the activities conducted by NGO Sarthi and whatever my parents used to organize with volunteers. So reciting poems, there's a poem that my father wrote, it's called Hold Me Papa Hold Me. So it's actually the cry of an unborn daughter to her parents to save her and not abort her. So that poem actually became the signature advocacy tool for our organizations. I used to recite that at public places, distribute pamphlets. I used to be clad in that yellow apron, so which had the message Kanya Bhrun Hatya Paap Hai, meaning female feticide is a sin and a crime. So that was in Hindi, Punjabi, English. So we used to wear those aprons, so I think. And also participating in street plays and dramas, becoming a fetus. So I think all of these things, doesn't matter how much I could process it or how much I knew the purpose behind it. The thing was that I was participating, and that's how that shaped me in entirety. And yeah, and since then I've never looked back.
Kudos to you both, and kudos to your parents for inculcating such values within you. That's just amazing. Now, both of you sisters have directed a documentary film on the climate change by the name of Earth in Flames. Please share with our viewers something more about the whole experience.
Yeah, thanks for bringing that up. In fact, Earth in Flames was the documentary was directed by both of us in 2009. And so we had mainly two missions to, you know, direct this documentary. One was to make sure that this documentary helps us reach out to more people, because, you know, that was a tool that we could use wherever we went for webinars, sessions and workshops in schools, colleges. So we would show that documentary and people would get to know about, you know, climate change and environmental preservation and how important this mission is to be taken forward. Second was that we had planned a road expedition of 4,500 kilometers to, you know, inspire people and make people aware in across 7 states of India. So we took that documentary along, and wherever we could stop, we could meet people. We would show that documentary and tell them that this is the work done by NGO Sarthi, and we need that everybody, you know, contributes to this mission and joins us and start working for environmental preservation.
Yeah, and regarding the process, I think both of us thoroughly enjoyed the process. We were quite young, so I was about 10 years old when we made this documentary, and Ananya must be around 5 or 6. So again, of course, our parents were there to guide us, but it was the entire effort was taken by us basically. So right from interviewing people, so you know, we would be traveling and we would see bikers on the road, some foreigners or someone, we would stop by, we would interview them. So we basically wanted to get the perspective of any layman person about what they think about climate change, how much they are aware, what they think can be done, things like that. So we interviewed, I think, very random people wherever we went. So public parks, we met a saint or a sage there, Rishi Munis, and then a foreigner like that, some school students, old people, children. So that was the process. Majorly our focus was on interviewing people basically, and then doing some research work, so background work. So I think that's where we also were first exposed to doing research, so finding out facts and all. Of course, our parents helped us in that because we weren't that pro in that, so finding newspaper articles and stuff like that. But then putting up that together, yes, both of us did that, so it was very basic editing. We used to be there with that editor and get that work done. So overall, I think it was a great learning experience. Plus, it helped us reach a lot of people, as Ananya said. So, yeah.
That's wonderful. Now, both of you sisters went on a 4,500-kilometer road expedition across 7 states of India with the message, Save Daughters, Save Earth. How did you conceptualize this and how long did the trip take you? Also, was your family and friends supportive in this initiative?
So yeah, I think the expedition was a wonderful, adventurous experience for us. I was the youngest volunteer and we were accompanied by our parents and 3 other volunteers of NGO Sathi. So we would stop at different places and villages, we would distribute pamphlets and free of cost CDs of Earth in Flames. And we would have a projector and we would show the villagers the movie and make them understand and make them actually aware about the problem of climate change. So I think it was a wonderful experience. We got to know about people, their grassroots level problems, and we met people from various cultures. And I think it was a successful idea to go to all these states and expand our vision, and we couldn't just limit this to our state, but we reached out to so many people. Yeah,
exactly. As Ananya said, I think the agenda behind going on this expedition majorly was reaching out to as many people as we can. And I think back then, social media wasn't that popular and it hadn't gained that popularity. So we thought we might actually go ourselves physically and talk to people. Ultimately, this idea of climate change had also to reach to grassroots level, the villagers, the women who use fossil fuels for cooking and wood, and the other villagers who don't have access to technology but they had to know about this idea. So that agenda basically took us on this expedition, and I think it was an amazing lifetime experience, I'd say, for both of us, because I think we were on a mission number one. We were stopping at different schools and colleges and villages, talking to people's interaction with people. That was, of course, there. But I think besides that, staying on road. So we couldn't find a hotel on the New Year Eve and we were there in Mumbai. So we stayed in the car that night. So things like that, when you get to experience life firsthand and you get hands-on experience. So I think those things in terms of social service plus enriching life, I think it has taught us a lot, that expedition particularly, and we successfully made impact through that.
Wow, what a story. And believe me, all the experiences that we have as a kid definitely charges up for the life and toughens up a person. Ananya, please share something about Susiksha, a mobile open-air school that you have started. How and when did you start it and what are your future plans?
So Susiksha program is basically a free mobile school that was founded by me and my sister in 2019. So this program is Empowerment Through Education initiative that was started in Darar village by us, as we adopted that village for overall development, and we hope to replicate that model to other villages very soon. So basically this is an idea to plug in the gap between the rural kids and the urban kids and make sure that the rural kids have the basic access to quality education. So through this program, we with the team of volunteers, a lot of experts, doctors and professionals in various fields, we together make sure that these students are well educated. They are given a chance to get awareness about society, politics and all the fields. Through this, we also try to instill leadership qualities in them. So basically, it is a very holistic program and it is not a curriculum like school. It is much beyond. So from extracurricular activities to recreational activities, awareness programs and overall educational programs. So we have a blend of all these things. And I think this initiative will go a long way, and we just make sure that the students are self-reliant in the future, they are job ready, and they have skills to be utilized in their professional career as well. So we have a skill center as well. Recently we started a stitching center especially for the women, so that they learn skills besides having education. So I think this is a holistic program that we started here.
Wonderful, and I wish you all the very best for this and the future projects that you have planned. Now Sanjoli, you became a senator for a day at the Australian Parliament, and that's just commendable. So iske bare mein aap hamare viewers ko kuch bataiye, aapko kis cheez ne inspire kiya and why did you choose to apply there?
जी बिल्कुल, मुझे ऑस्ट्रेलियन पार्लियामेंट में एक दिन का एमपी बनने का मौका मिला, और ये इस दिन हमने प्राइम मिनिस्टर वहाँ के जो हैं स्कॉट मॉरिसन, उनको हमने एक चार्टर दिया, तो मैं और कुछ और हमारे साथ गर्ल्स थी जिन्होंने पार्लियामेंट को टेक ओवर किया था एक दिन के लिए. हम लोग एमपी के चेयर पे, हम उनकी कुर्सी में बैठे थे और हमने पॉलिसीज़ के ऊपर सोचा था. तो उसके दौरान हमने वहाँ के प्राइम मिनिस्टर को एक चार्टर दिया, वेमेंस चार्टर करके, जिसमें हमने बात करी कि क्यों पॉलिटिक्स जो है वो मेल डोमिनेटेड फील्ड रहता है और क्यों वेमेन को इक्वल रिप्रेजेंटेशन नहीं मिलती और उनको एक सेफ वर्किंग स्पेस नहीं दिया जाता पॉलिटिक्स में. तो हमें उनसे प्रधानमंत्री जी से मिलने का मौका मिला, बहुत सारे वहाँ के केंद्रीय मिनिस्टर्स जो थे और एमपीज थे उनके साथ, उनकी कुर्सी में बैठने का मौका मिला. वहाँ पे जो सेनेट है जो हमारे राज्यसभा के बराबर है, वहाँ की प्रोसीडिंग्स सेशन में बैठने का मौका मिला. हमने अपनी बात रखी वहाँ पर कि हम एज यूथ ऑफ टुडे हम क्या सोचते हैं कि क्या मुद्दे ज़रूरी हैं, किस पे एक्शन लेना इमिडिएटली ज़रूरी है. और खुश नसीबी की बात यह है कि हमारी उम्र के लोगों को, यूथ को उन्होंने आगे आने का मौका दिया, हमें सुना, हमारी सुनवाई हुई. और मेरी क्लाइमेट चेंज के ऊपर स्पीच वहाँ पर पढ़ी गई. वहाँ के पार्टी के जो लीडर हैं सेनेटर रिचर्ड डी नेटली ग्रीन्स पार्टी से, उन्होंने क्लाइमेट चेंज पर मेरी स्पीच पढ़ी जो कि आगे मीडिया में हाईलाइट किया गया और प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस मुझे एड्रेस करने का मौका मिला, नेशनल मीडिया ने मेरा इंटरव्यू लिया. तो इसके द्वारा मैं अपनी बात, आई कुड कन्वे माय मैसेज टू द एंटायर वर्ल्ड. आई हैड ऑलरेडी बीन वर्किंग ऑन क्लाइमेट चेंज हियर, बट दैट वाज अनदर नेक्स्ट स्टेप एंड आई थिंक इट वाज अ ह्यूज ऑनर फॉर मी टू बी देयर. एंड यस, आई रियली वांट दैट मोर वुमेन गेट दैट अपॉर्चुनिटी, मे बी इन ऑस्ट्रेलिया और इंडिया, बट यस वी वांट मोर पीपल टू कम फॉरवर्ड. एंड इन फैक्ट आई टेक दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी टू मेंशन दैट दिस सेम ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इज ब्रिंगिंग गर्ल्स टेक ओवर पार्लियामेंट टू इंडिया एज वेल. So I am in the organizing committee and I'm the India spokesperson. So I would love to have young women apply for that. Just Google Jaziri Australia and find this opportunity and go for it, because again, women should be in politics and why not?
Oh yes, why not? And I can see a future politician here, and it's such a wonderful feeling. And believe me, youth like you can definitely bring a change in the society, and that's just so great. Ananya, my next question to you is that your work did not stop during pandemic. In fact, it became more streamlined. How did you make it possible?
Undoubtedly, the pandemic, especially the lockdown, affected Sushiksha program. In the sense, the Sushiksha program was in infancy stage at that time. But we utilized the pandemic time in expanding our NGO, redefining the curriculum, and as and when the government started relaxing their norms for coronavirus, so we started having small batches and we took care of the precautions and all. And now it is going on very well. We have a lot of volunteers that help us and ensure that we have proper sanitization and mask system. So now we are very happy for the fact that if this Sushiksha program would have stopped or we would have stepped back, maybe these students would have gone to seek work at dhabas or factories and work as child laborers. You know, because we couldn't continue with online classes because they don't have that basic access to digital media and technology, unfortunately. So, but now, as we are back to the village, we can work now. I think we are very happy for that fact that they are again interested in seeking education, and now again we can see those smiles on their faces and they come running excited on the weekend classes at Sushiksha.
That's true. Sajoli, my next question is to you, and I've been waiting to ask this question from the very beginning of the interview. Why did you choose to return to India from Australia after studying a degree in international security?
Well, that's an interesting one. और मुझे लगता है कि काफी लोगों के दिमाग में ये सवाल जरूर होगा और मुझसे काफी दफा पूछा भी जाता है कि आप ऑस्ट्रेलिया छोड़कर इंडिया क्यों आए? In fact, बिल्कुल ये उल्टा ट्रेंड है, लोग यहाँ से बाहर जाते हैं. But it was, I think, my calling towards India, the commitment towards service I'd already made. तो जो हमने गांव गोद लिया हुआ है हरियाणा में, वहाँ पर और जो हम सुशिक्षा प्रोग्राम चला रहे हैं, तो इन सारी चीज़ों के towards I had a commitment. तो मुझे मैं आई वापस. In fact, मेरा purpose of going abroad था ही यही कि मैं वहाँ की वर्ल्ड क्लास एजुकेशन, बेस्ट एजुकेशन, स्किल्स और एक्सपोजर लेकर आऊँ, मेरे नज़रिए में कुछ बदलाव आए. क्योंकि अक्सर क्या होता है, हम कुछ बबल्स में ही अपने आप को सीमित रखते हैं. वी रिमेन इन बबल्स एंड वी डो नॉट नो अबाउट द वर्ल्ड आउटसाइड. दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी गेव मी, स्टडिंग अब्रॉड बेसिकली गेव मी एन अपॉर्चुनिटी टू बर्स्ट दैट बबल एंड टॉक टू डिफरेंट पीपल फ्रॉम ऑल वॉक्स ऑफ लाइफ, गेट एक्सपोजर. तो उसके कारण मुझे लगता है मेरे में बहुत ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन आई है. और फिर बिल्कुल वापस आकर गांव में काम करना, लोगों की सेवा करना, माइट साउंड क्लीशे बट आई एक्चुअली मीन इट, मुझे बहुत खुशी मिलती है. और हमने बहुत सारे और नए प्रोजेक्ट्स लॉन्च कर रहे हैं जब से मैं आई हूँ वापस ऑस्ट्रेलिया से. एंड अनन्या एंड आई वर्क टुगेदर एंड इट इज़ सो मच फन, वी एंजॉय इट एंड इट्स डीपली सैटिस्फाइंग. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट, आई थिंक चैलेंजेस बिल्कुल आते हैं, हर डिसीजन, हर चॉइस में चैलेंजेस हैं. मैं वहाँ थी, वहाँ अलग चैलेंज थे, यहाँ पर अब उनकी डिफरेंट नेचर है. बट येस, आई थिंक आई वुड से मेजरली द वर्क कल्चर इज़ वेरी डिफरेंट एंड द पर्सपेक्टिव एंड थिंकिंग ऑफ पीपल. वी आर स्टिल डिवेलपिंग कंट्री, दे आर ऑलरेडी डिवेलप्ड, सो थिंग्स आर ईजियर देयर. वहाँ पर कोई काम करना चाहते हो बहुत आसान है, यहाँ थोड़ा सा मुश्किल होता है लोगों को समझाना, काम करवाना. और स्पेशली जब आप एक सोशल वर्क के स्फीयर में है, इट इज़ अ लिटिल चैलेंजिंग. बट अगेन चैलेंजेस आर अ पार्ट ऑफ लाइफ एंड वी टेक देम एज एन अपॉर्चुनिटी. And yes, we have aced it so far.
That's great. So how do you think that a change can be brought about in our society to save and empower a girl child? What steps should be taken?
Regarding steps to empower and save girl child, I think first of all, the fact that we need to save the girl child is problematic in itself, I believe. Why don't we talk about saving the boys? But we always talk about saving the girls. Why did we create such a situation? So first we need to contemplate on that. We need to think why girls are not preferred as much as boys. Why don't we simply accept what God is gifting to us in the form of a child? Why do we discriminate? So that's one introspection that we need. Hum apne andar jhaank ke dekhe ki kyun hum bete aur beti mein bhedbhav karte aur kyun aisi situation paida hoti ki beti ko bachana pade. उसके बाद वहीं से फिर आता है रोल घर का, कि भी जैसे हमने पहले भी बात करी कि किस तरह से माता पिता का कितना बड़ा रोल रहता है घर में, दादा दादी का रोल, सारी फैमिली का, कि कैसे वो बेटी को कम इम्पोर्टेंस देकर और बेटे को ज़्यादा इम्पोर्टेंस देते हैं कि वो हमारे कुल वंश बनेगा, हमारा घर का नाम आगे लेकर जाएगा एंड थिंग्स लाइक दैट. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी नीड टू स्टॉप डिस्क्रिमिनेशन एट होम. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी नीड टू वेलकम गर्ल्स, वी नीड टू एक्सेप्ट देम एज हु दे आर. वो लड़की जो है वो हाइट कैसी भी है, वेट कैसी भी है, कॉम्प्लेक्शन कैसा भी है, कैपेबिलिटीज कैसी भी है, बियॉन्ड दैट हमें उसके आगे सोचना होगा कि वो एक इंसान है और हम उसको एक इंसान की तरह देखें, उसकी काबिलियत पर पूरा विश्वास करें और वो पक्का आपको एक दिन कुछ ना कुछ करके दिखाएगी। दूसरा फिर रोल आते हैं स्कूल्स का। स्कूल में भी इक्वालिटी नाम की चीज़ होनी चाहिए। कुछ स्कूल्स में बिल्कुल होती है, कहीं में नहीं। तो कहीं पर रिस्ट्रिक्ट ना किया जाए कि कुछ स्पोर्ट्स जो है बॉयज़ ही खेलेंगे या कोई हैवी वर्क है वो बॉयज़ कर सकते हैं। एक्सपोजर और अपॉर्चुनिटी, वही बात आती है कि एक्सेस देना, पहुंच देना, रीच जो है हर एक को मिलना चाहिए। गर्ल शुड बी एबल टू एक्सेस अपॉर्चुनिटीज एंड इट शुड बी चॉइस, राइट? सो इट शुडन्ट बी, देयर शुडन्ट बी रिस्ट्रिक्शंस इन दीज केसेस। एंड फाइनली आई थिंक द गवर्नमेंट हैज़ अ मैसिव रोल टू प्ले इन दिस, स्पेशली इन केस ऑफ लो इनकम फैमिलीज, जहाँ पर जिनका मेन डर ये होता है कि अगर लड़की घर रुकेगी तो वो अनसेफ रहेगी, उसके क्राइम और रेप के चांसेस काफ़ी ज़्यादा रहते हैं, छेड़छाड़ के चांसेस। तो उस केस में ऑफकोर्स इंडिविजुअल से ज़्यादा गवर्नमेंट का रोल आता है कि वो सेफ्टी और सिक्योरिटी ऑफ वेमेन का ध्यान रखे, चाहे वो CCTV कैमराज इंस्टॉल करना है, पुलिस पेट्रोलिंग है, या फिर फियर ऑफ लॉ क्रिएट करना है कि अगर आप ऐसा कुछ करते तो ये हो सकता है उसका नतीजा। सो समथिंग लाइक दैट, आई थिंक द गवर्नमेंट नीड्स टू कम फॉरवर्ड। वी डिड गेट द PCPNDT एक्ट अगेंस्ट अबॉर्शंस, वी हैव गॉटन लॉज टाइम एंड अगेन, बट वी नीड, वॉट वी नीड इज स्ट्रोंगर इम्प्लीमेंटेशन एंड मॉनिटरिंग ऑफ दोज। कितने रिडंडेंट लॉज हैं और कितने जो स्टिल रेलिवेंट हैं उनको कैसे ठीक किया जा सकता है। आज के ज़माने में क्यों लड़की सेफली कॉलेज से शाम को अंधेरे में घर नहीं आ सकती, अगर हम वैसे क्वालिटी की बात करते वैसे वो रात को काम नहीं कर सकती, बस उसके लिए अनसेफ है, ऑफिस अनसेफ है, कितनी जगह वर्क प्लेसेस पे जो है छेड़छाड़ होती है, घरों में सेफ नहीं है क्योंकि उनके अपने ही अंकल्स और ब्रदर्स और ये सब भी परपेट्रेटर्स ऑफ क्राइम होते हैं, ठीक है? तो लड़की कहीं भी सेफ नहीं है, ठीक है? पैंडेमिक के में, लॉकडाउन में कितने ज़्यादा डोमेस्टिक वायलेंस के केसेस आए, वेमेन वर अनसेफ इन देयर ओन होम्स, विच इज सच अ टेरिबल फैक्ट। वी आर इन 21st century एंड दिस इज स्टिल हैपनिंग। तो आई थिंक वी नीड टू एड्रेस दिस कलेक्टिवली। प्राइवेट सेक्टर भी इसमें रोल प्ले कर सकता है, इस तरह के प्रोग्राम्स बनाकर अपने वर्क स्पेसेस को सेफ करके। पब्लिक सेक्टर का तो बहुत बड़ा रोल है, फैमिलीज का रोल है, NGOs इसमें बहुत कुछ कर सकती हैं, अवेयरनेस और सेंसिटाइजिंग, बॉयज़ को समझाया जाए, उनको अवेयरनेस और एजुकेशन दी जाए, हाउ टू ट्रीट वेमेन इक्वली, थिंग्स लाइक दैट। आई थिंक वी एज अ सोसाइटी नीड टू कम फॉरवर्ड एंड फॉर दैट आई थिंक एजुकेशन इज द की एंड दैट इज़ वाई वी ऑल्सो स्टार्टेड वर्किंग ऑन दिस, बिकॉज अंटिल वी आर educated and aware, I don't think we can solve these problems. So yes, that's what we can do to empower women. And then finally, I think it is in the hands of women, जो already जिनके पास सारी opportunities हैं, जो urban areas से, privileged communities से आते हैं, उनको अपने आप को prove करके दिखाना होगा, if because they can set an example for others. That see, अगर औरतों को मौका दिया जाए तो ये सब कर सकती हैं। अगर हम उस एक लग्जरी को और उस अपॉर्चुनिटी को वेस्ट होने देते हैं, अपना टाइम वेस्ट करते हैं, या फिर हम अपनी प्रायोरिटीज़ कुछ और बनाते हैं, पार्टी करना और फैशन और ये सब, आई डोंट क्रिटिसाइज दैट, दैट इज़ नॉट रॉन्ग इन एनी सेंस, बट चैनलाइजिंग दैट टूवर्ड्स अ कंस्ट्रक्टिव सेंस, आई थिंक दैट्स हाउ वी शैल बी एबल टू प्रूव आवरसेल्व्स टू, बिकॉज येस इट्स ऑन अस टू।
And to add, in fact, we both wrote a letter to the Prime Minister suggesting 14 solutions to how to save girl child and reduce the problem of female feticide in India. And I think those few solutions have been fortunately been implemented by the government. And in our city, we had police patrolling started, and then we had a women police station installed here. So I think these steps, collective effort of the society, individuals and government, I think can make a big difference.
Kya baat hai, amazing. Ananya, how much credit do you give to yourself and to others in your life for being women influencers? And what skills do you think one needs to be an influencer?
So I think the credit for what I am today is primarily it goes to my parents, again, because they gave the direction, grooming and environment, and they instilled the values in me. Secondly would be my teachers, who some of the teachers showed more confidence in me than I had. Then I would like to give credit to the beneficiaries. It is rightly said that there is no value of a solution when there isn't a problem. So there were a lot of social issues, but when we started working for it, what kept me moving was that I had transformed the lives of so many people. I could see those, you know, the spark in their eyes, and they would come thanking all of us that you have helped us. You know, this girl is because of you in the family. We have tried to accept this girl just because of you. So I think this credit is distributed to these people. And if I talk about what women need to be women influencers, I think primarily three things are required. Number one is passion. If a woman finds meaning in life or something called passion, that I can give my service, my time and efforts into this particular thing, that is, I think, the first step. And second would be self-belief. So if a woman won't believe in herself, I think that is undeniable, that the society, the people will of course criticize, and they would show low confidence in the woman. But the woman has to be fearless, has to believe in herself that yes, she can. And I think third would be her determination, that despite all the criticism, despite all the challenges and problem, I have to keep moving and not look back. So I think, of course, these things, you know, change according to people, where they come from and overall. But I think these three basic things can help a woman, you know, be a woman influencer. And I think women are already strong. If they just accept it, that they are equal as men, and start considering it as a fact, I think each woman is an influencer, may it be a homemaker or a change maker out in the society.
Wow, such wise words coming from a 17-year-old, that's just wonderful. Now, since both of you are helping women at the grassroots level, what do you think is the bigger problem? Male mindset who believe that they are superior, or female mindset who are made to think only in a certain way from the very beginning?
I think unfortunately this thing or this problem is imbibed in our society now. मुझे ऐसे लगता है कि ये जो problem है उसका शुरुआत घरों से होता है, from the childhood, from the very beginning. जब एक लड़के की और एक लड़की की grooming बिल्कुल different होती है. A boy is told that he cannot cry. A boy is very bold. He is has masculinity. ऐसे जब words, ऐसे जब phrases families में use होते हैं, a girl is taught that you have to just play with the Barbie doll and go to the kitchen in the future. You cannot think of building a career, then who will marry you? So these are very common things in the Indian society. And I think this is the major cause of a problem, that women start considering them as inferiors, because that particular environment is given to them, that they cannot think themselves as equals. I think males also have this thing that they, of course, we have some males that would support women in their rights and would fight for them. But at the same time, this major problem exists, especially this orthodox mindset in especially the rural areas, that men are superior, and this thing is forced upon women. And I think then they're left with no option, and they consider themselves that they are not as much as men can do.
Absolutely, I totally agree. I think it starts from home, how our parents form that environment, what do they instill in their impressionable minds, and then it comes to the school, how teachers basically treat their male and female students, and of course then the society keeps reinforcing these things. तो अगर हमें बचपन से ये सिखाया जाए कि ठीक है कि आप और आप उतने ही काबिल हो, आपके लिए सेम अपॉर्चुनिटी है, आपके ऊपर है, अब आप अपने आप को प्रूव करके दिखाओ. तो हमेशा हम लड़कों को स्ट्रांग का वो टैग देते, तो उनको बचपन से ही दे आर कॉन्फिडेंट, और लड़कियों को दबाया जाता है कि अरे आपने तो अगले घर में जाना है, दूसरे घर में, पराया धन, ऑल ऑफ दोज कॉन्सेप्ट. तो बिल्कुल जैसे अनन्या ने बोला कि ये सारे अगर हम नोशंस बदल दें, और आई थिंक इट इज़ हाई टाइम नाउ दैट वी शुड चेंज द सिनेरियो. और उसके कारण, और ऑब्वियसली बाकी कुछ केसेस में वुमेन आर सब्जेक्ट टू वायलेंस एंड केसेस ऑफ डोमेस्टिक वायलेंस और क्राइम्स अगेंस्ट वुमेन लाइक हरासमेंट और अब्यूज और रेप्स, दे आई थिंक समवेयर कम फ्रॉम टॉक्सिक male mentality, that they are superior and women are objects or they are subjects. So yes, I think it works both ways, and I think elders are to blame for this kind of
and I think that now it's time to think like both males and females are individuals. We need to just get away from the gender roles and consider both as individuals and how they do as individuals, instead of just women and men.
That's great, and a lot is changing with time too. Ananya, you study psychology, So what role does intersectionality play in women's mental health?
Yeah, so for my friends who don't know what intersectionality means, so it is basically when different identities overlap each other and leaves the person worse off. So yes, I study psychology, and as per my knowledge, I think this thing of course affects the women's mental health. When a woman is told each and every time that she has a tag or label of a woman, she would then think herself as inferior. So we start connecting one label, one identity with the other, instead of just considering women as an individual. So a woman is now, if we talk about India, so a woman would be labeled as because of a gender role, then her color, her race. So all these identities together, I think, affects the mental health of a woman. And I think if a woman is considered just as an individual, I think that would be then neutral and help women to rise. And I think there is one term in psychology, imposter syndrome, which also means that women start thinking, even the trailblazers or the women who are doing great in their career, they start thinking that we are not, we are not worth achieving all this, because that is somewhere, you know, imbibed in our minds and in our society, that women cannot consider themselves as doing great, or they cannot do great in their career or in life. So I think when this changes from grassroots level, I think there would be a big social change.
That's right. Ananya and Sanjoli, my next question is for both of you. You have mentioned about the inspiring and constructive role of your parents in your life and the work that you have always pursued. Can you please elaborate more on this for our viewers?
Thank you for that question. I believe that my parents have a very big role, great contribution in what we are presently. And they have supported us throughout the journey, physically, morally, financially, in all the best ways they could. And I think they have given us the direction to work. They brought us into this field, but later on we found our true calling in this. So it has been a very collective effort of me, my sister, and the support given by our parents. So it could have been possible that we both have great vision and maybe our parents aren't supporting, but fortunately that wasn't the case. So with whatever idea we present them, or whatever project we have in our mind, they are the ones to acknowledge it, accept it, and then appreciate it. And I think this is what a child can desire for, and luckily we have those parents who always support us in whatever task we take up, and they are the backbone of whatever we do, because somewhere this vision of ours has come in the blood, I guess, from my parents. We have seen them working so hard, contribute to the society, so the values and overall things come from them. So I think this collective effort has made sure that we do great for the society and make a social impact, I think.
So good to know about all this. And you know what? This can be food for thought for a lot of parents who are watching this show. Sanjoli and Ananya, what message would you like to give to all the girls who are watching this show and want to follow your footsteps?
So here I'm reminded of my favorite quotation by Oprah Winfrey. That says that the biggest adventure of life is to lead a life of your dreams. So to all the girls watching this, I think first of all, find your true calling, your dream, your passion. And in case you are being tortured, or you are facing any harassment, discrimination in any capacity, then please reach out for help. You know, it is very important to reach out to help, so that you are not left in that bubble, and you're not left in that bubble for the entire life further. And I think seeking out help is most important thing. And then believe in yourself that you can do it. And of course, when there's to every problem, I think there is a way. Find a way or make your own way.
Yeah, to add to that, I think very well Ananya said those things. But I think it's important to be you. Just be you. I think that's what I would say. Don't compare yourself with other women. Everyone has different circumstances and everyone is unique. You can't compare yourself or put yourself in others' place. So I think it's important to embrace your strengths, your limitations, your qualities. Whoever you are, whatever makes you, even your physical appearance and all, whatever you are, basically. Number two would be looking for the right role models. I personally believe in having the right role models and drawing inspiration. There should be some source of inspiration. आपके लिए कोई एक प्रेरणा स्रोत्र होना बहुत जरूरी है कि जहाँ से आप सीखें और प्रेरणा पाएं. तो जैसे मेरे लिए मेरी मदर, मेरे मिशेल ओबामा, मलाला यूसुफजई, माया एंजलो एंड रोजा पार्क्स, दीज सम फिनोमिनल वुमेन, सरोजनी नायडू. सो ऑल ऑफ दीज वुमेन आई थिंक दे have really inspired me. And then I would see other young women in Australia and India who are leading from the forefront and how they are doing so well. तो हम अगर glamorous world के celebrities को हम अपने role model माने तो I think there is a lack of bond, क्योंकि हम connect नहीं कर सकते, उनसे relate नहीं कर सकते, उनकी दुनिया बिल्कुल अलग है. हम कोई ऐसा role model ढूंढें जो जिससे हम connect कर पाएँ और उनसे हम कुछ सीख के हम बेटर बन पाएँ. सो दैट इज़ इम्पॉर्टेंट आई थिंक. एंड फाइनली आई थिंक इट इज़ इम्पॉर्टेंट टू गेन अ लॉट ऑफ एक्सपीरियंसेस एंड एक्सपोजर. डोंट रिस्ट्रिक्ट योर सेल्फ. कोई अगर अपॉर्चुनिटी मिलती है, देखिए उसको कि आप उसको अवेल कर पाएँ एंड यू गो अहेड. बिकॉज आई थिंक इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर यू टू कंटिन्यूसली वर्क ऑन योर सेल्फ, इम्प्रूव हु यू आर, होन योर स्किल्स. So I think your, whether it's your interpersonal skills, your communication, networking, I think it's very important. And then taking up leadership roles. So being proactive in that sense helps a lot. So both of us personally have always embraced taking up leadership roles and being proactive, whether in school, in society, or in our educational institutions and otherwise. So yeah, but overall, I think we are very honored to hear that women would and young girls would like to follow our footsteps. And we started from a small step, and I think you all can do that too. So yeah, good luck with whatever action you take, and let's all be a part of the change making process.
Absolutely fantastic. Your confidence is so contagious that I don't know about others, but I am totally charged up. So before we say goodbye to you, what are your thoughts about our talk show?
Thank you so much, Sada, for inviting both of us to your amazing talk show. And it is, I think, a great platform to reach out to other women. And it would be great if at least even one woman gets inspired watching this video. So thank you so much for having us. And I think we enjoyed this interview. It was a great experience for us. Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. Thanks to you, Sada, for giving us this opportunity and for letting us share our thoughts, our journey. And I hope, yes, young women come forward. And thanks to you and kudos to you and your entire team working for a great cause. And I think you people are highlighting the women who are otherwise not highlighted by the national media. They're left out. So unsung heroes, I think, are what you're highlighting. So I'm really proud of you all, and keep going and set higher benchmarks for other women as well. Thank you, and have a wonderful time.
Thank you, Sanjoli and Ananya, for coming on our show and sharing with our viewers your inspiring story and the phenomenal work that you are doing. Congratulations and more power to you. Women Influencers Talk Show is so proud to serve as a platform for such causes. Thank you so much for joining us. So if you're new here, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel, share the link of this video with your family and friends, and give a thumbs up if you like this video. So till we meet next time again, please take care of yourself, stay healthy, stay safe, and always be happy.